Every time I wake up, I check my blood sugar because I have type 1 diabetes, give myself my long-acting insulin, try to eat healthy, but sometimes it's just a granola bar, have some coffee. I have a lot of plants in my room. It's so much fun to watch something grow. It's very, very therapeutic, I would say. But in the morning, just try to stay cool, calm, and collected. There's usually a lot going on each day. The great thing is where I live is 3-minute walk from campus. So it's just like a perfect place to be. Leading into the early afternoon, we have some type of lecture. So usually I'm preparing myself for, I would say, acquiring new knowledge in the morning. And then in the afternoon, I try to learn what we just learned that day. So we just had a quiz, and not trying to brag, but I passed. Basically every week we have a quiz. I find them to be very helpful. I think a lot of my classmates find them to be very helpful. They're not super stressful. The goal is just to be making sure that you're digesting all of the material you're learning each week.
So the liaison meeting is a great opportunity for students and faculty to talk. I think we're all on the same team and we're all trying to figure out how we can improve the curriculum. So we're gonna start this meeting today talking about what went well for the last block, what are things that could have been improved, and then we're gonna hand it over to the current block liaisons for the renal block, which is what we're on now, and we're gonna talk to them about what's going well with their block and what are things that can be improved as the block is happening. And then we'll just open it up to the floor to see what are things that people are feeling.
So I think the liaison meeting went pretty well. We talked about all the things we wanted to cover. We all had a session on how to approach taking a history. And that session was led by Dr. Joseph Maiden, who I think is like a fan favorite of all the students. And students really liked the session. And we gave some feedback to faculty that we actually would like that session sooner in the school year. Hopefully they'll make that change for future students. We have a curriculum on campus where we learn about various diagnostic testings and how to approach statistics, how to communicate statistics. So during the meeting yesterday, we brought up the idea of creating a working group of students who can advise the curriculum on how to improve the EBM curriculum. And Dr. Heron responded wonderfully, and he will help us create this working group. And it's things like that that make the liaison meeting so successful. Jefferson has leaned into the idea that we want to be learning from clinicians. So twice a week we do a case-based learning session. We get a very basic chief complaint, like you have a patient coming in with fever, and we just ask questions. And we have a clinician there to steer us in a direction they think we should be steered in. At the end of the Tuesday session, we come up with 10 learning objectives. So one learning objective for each individual. And the goal is that you take this learning objective and you research it for the next couple days. And then on the Thursday session, everyone presents on their objective. At the end of Thursday, we get learning objectives for the week. So those learning objectives are what the quiz is based off of on Fridays. So we divvy up those learning objectives and then we all work on them as a group. Normally on Fridays, we do case vignettes where we have some type of clinical professor come in and talk to us about the conditions we learned that week and kind of synthesize all the information. So today's case vignettes on acute kidney injury, but my brother is in town from California and we're planning on going to the Philadelphia Flower Show. So I will be watching those lectures later from the comforts of the library or my bedroom.
So when we changed to Jeff MD, we made the curriculum much more centralized within the dean's office. The curriculum in the past, the so-called 2+2 curriculum, where the first 2 years was preclinical, the first year being normal, second year being abnormal. Then the students entered the clinical realm in year 3 and year 4. That traditional model was really put on its end by Jeff MD, in which we realized what a doctor's gonna have to do 20 years from now is unrecognizable to what they're doing now, and we had to try to be nimble enough to train them to be able to do that. And that means much more active learning, much more development of cognitive skills, understanding how to obtain information, how to access information, how to sort it out, how to apply. And by changing the curriculum, we ended up with a much more centralized structure. And one of the great things about Jefferson, despite its size, is it has a real feeling of family and community. The reality is there's a comfort in the familiar, and when that's taken away from you, then you need to start swimming. You can't tread water. We have to move forward. And I think that this has really energized the team.
I mean, last year, it was pretty abrupt, honestly. So we were 100% on campus. We had all of our lectures on campus. We had dissection in person. We had case-based learning in person. I mean, very traditional. And then in mid-March, we just within, I think it was like March 13th was when things started shutting down. And then pretty quickly, everything went virtual. And then we came back to campus in July. And a big thing that that my class, like the class of 2023, the big thing that was a priority for us was and continues to be supporting the incoming first year students. And once we came back, we kind of just like jumped right back into the curriculum. We started initially in July, we started completely virtual with the intent to do sort of like a hybrid curriculum after a few weeks. And so we started virtual. And then we started doing case-based learning in person, which was really, that's actually gone much more smoothly than I expected. My CBL, there are 10 of us, and then we have a facilitator, and we're actually in a lecture hall. So we have case-based learning in person. The faculty created kind of like a truncated version of clinical skills. So we had like a 45-minute in-person experience where we learned various clinical skills last block, and then we had our clinical skills exam in person, which was really was really nice. That was actually a really interesting experience. For that, we went into an exam room and we did telemedicine basically with a standardized patient where we interviewed them over the computer. They were just set up there and we just interviewed them, did a history with them. And then there was a mannequin on an exam table behind us. And so we just like vocalized to the person on the computer what we were doing on the physical exam with the dummy behind us. We also have something called clinical experience, where last year we did clinical experience in various Jefferson hospitals where we would go in and do a social determinants of health screen for patients that were in the hospital. And so last year we did that in person, but this year they developed a pretty robust system for us to do that exact same thing, but via telemedicine. And so that I got to experience that a few weeks ago, and that was incredible. That was a really, really awesome experience. In general, my class is starting to gear up for step one studying. And that's in general, just like a very private, personal experience. So I don't even know what beginning of second year would have looked like last year. I imagine it would have been very similar to what I'm doing right now, actually. We study all the time, and you study with your group or like by yourself. But I don't think, as a first year student last year and as a second year student now, I don't think my education is being affected negatively at all. And if anything, I feel like I've gotten a lot out of this experience. What faculty has done exceedingly well is they've communicated with us consistently about what is expected of us, what are they doing for us. A big thing that my class cared about was doing anatomy dissection in person. We missed the abdominal dissection in the spring. We kind of missed the pelvic dissection in the fall this past block. And we really argued hard for that. And now the faculty like created an experience for us to go in and actually do dissection in person. I mean, I've had the good fortune of being a liaison, and I've been able to like see behind the scenes about all that goes into these decisions. And I think faculty's done an incredible job of making sure that our education is as good as it can be.